Had a question from someone that wanted to know, is psoriasis contagious? Well, that's a big fat no, it's not contagious. Psoriasis is an autoimmune disease. It's an immune problem. And there's red, scaly plaques on the skin. And what's happening is there's certain parts of the skin that is replacing itself too fast, within 3 days, when it should be replacing itself within like 28 days. So there's a lot of problems on the skin, and there it could be some itchiness involved. Now, to figure out what psoriasis is, we need clues. So here are some of the triggers. Taking antibiotics can trigger this condition. Stress can trigger it. Having an infection, especially strep or candida. Omega-6 fatty acids, which are certain unsaturated fatty acids that are inflammatory, create inflammation of the gut. Statins, which is interesting. What do statins do? They block cholesterol. So we'll come back to that. And in the winter, there's a worsening of psoriasis. I wonder why that is. Well, if we take a look at some other clues, steroids do help, and it's part of a treatment that a lot of doctors recommend for psoriasis. Problem is, there's side effects, right? Vitamin D creams do help, and so does UV light. Okay, what does UV light do? Well, first of all, it's a therapy directly in the skin, but also certain UV frequencies can increase vitamin D in the body. If you do a deep dive with psoriasis, they've isolated part of your immune system being a problem. There's an excessive amount of the T helper cell 17 going on. So it's an overactive T helper 17 cell, which is producing too much of this pro-inflammatory cytokine. So basically, we have this overactive immune cell that's creating this inflammation. And when this cell is too high, it can trigger an autoimmune condition where your body starts to attack itself. And so I did a real huge search on what could suppress this cell, what could suppress this cytokine. And guess what came up? Vitamin D. Now, what does vitamin D have to do with that? It helps modulate or calm and control an overactive immune system. So vitamin D is very, very important in helping to minimize the side effects from autoimmune conditions. You'd have to take a bit more than usual, like 30 to 40,000 units per day. Now, the next recommendation is bile salts. Bile salts can increase the vitamin D receptor. So if there's some type of problem where you can't absorb vitamin D, bile salts can actually help you absorb it. Now, Tutka is a very specific type of bile salt because there's several. This is another recommendation. In addition to regular bile salts, I would take both of those, and I would take them on an empty stomach. I would take in the morning, take one, and then in the afternoon, take maybe another one, and maybe take one with meals. Taking probiotics have been shown to decrease the symptoms of psoriasis as well, simply because the dysfunction originates in your gut, usually from an antibiotic or an infection or something you're consuming that might have triggered it. And then another recommendation would be cod liver oil. Cod liver oil is very high in vitamin D, vitamin A, and omega-3 fatty acids, which are anti-inflammatory, that counters the omega-6 fatty acids. And because there's a gut problem, which means there's a permeability problem, there could be a leaky gut, you may want to try carnivore for a while, just because that might decrease the inflammation in your gut. Now, a couple last things I want to mention. Of course, it's worse in the winter because there's not a lot of sun, so there's going to be less vitamin D. People with psoriasis need to be taking a very good amount of vitamin D. Of course, also take vitamin K2 with it. Now, what's the relationship between statins and vitamin D? Well, take a wild guess what vitamin D is made from. Cholesterol in your skin. So the UV light hits the skin, it turns the cholesterol into a pre-vitamin D, which is then converted into an active form of vitamin D through the kidney and the liver. So taking statins can decrease your overall vitamin D levels. All right, there you have it. And if you want additional information on psoriasis, I did another video on it. You can check it out. I put it down below. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.